San Bernardino, one of the oldest communities in California, the city has a long and colorful history. Home to approximately 210,000 people, San Bernardino hosts many historic institutions. For example, there is the Santa Fe Depot, which opened in 1918. There's also the Dorothy Ingram Library, named in 1977 after San Bernardino County's first African-American schoolteacher. Located in the heart of downtown is another well-known city jewel, the California Theater. The Art Deco-style masterpiece opened in 1928 and showcased live vaudeville performances as well as full-length feature films between the 1930s and 1960s, a period many have referred to as the Golden Age of Hollywood. The lavish movie palace's grand opening kicked off in high gear with the premiere of the silent film Street Angel. The film's lead actress, Janet Gaynor, was in attendance for the spectacle, much to the delight of the local newspapers. Audiences of the era had much to be excited about, as many well-known stars frequented the California during the period. Some of its well-known visitors included Clark Gable, Shirley Temple, Tony Curtis, and Will Rogers, with Rogers perhaps being the most notable. Rogers, a popular vaudeville performer, movie actor, and radio personality, gave the last performance of his life at the California in 1935. A few months after his visit, he and aviator Wiley Post perished in a plane crash over Alaska. However, even in death, Rogers' legacy with the theater still lived on. In his honor, the California named what it now is reception room after him. As further proof of Rogers' immense impact, muralist Ken Twitchell painted two larger-than-life murals of the actor on the exterior of the theater in 1997. Audiences galore filled the 1,718-seat auditorium during the 1930s and 40s. During this time, studio directors used the California to test run many of the feature films they had not yet released nationally. One of these films was the 1939 blockbuster, The Wizard of Oz. Judy Garland's signature song, Somewhere Over the Rainbow, was ultimately saved from elimination in the final film thanks to the enthusiastic response of the theater audience who attended the special sneak peek. The 1960s saw the decline of the studio-era system as well as movie audiences. It was in 1969 that the California showcased its last feature films of the era with What Happened to Aunt Alice and How to Commit Marriage. Despite this massive change, the theater never closed down. This was thanks in large part to C.L. and Alexandra Jenks, co-owners of the San Bernardino Civic Light Opera, which ran the theater during this time. Current California Theater house manager Mark Benjamin can attest to this.
They were directly responsible for saving the California Theater from destruction. Their artistry and vision inspired a generation of theatergoers and performers, and their legacy continues to set the standard for performances to this day.
The theater fell into disrepair during the 1970s and 80s, but became revitalized again in the 1990s, when San Bernardino's Economic Development Agency took over ownership. Now known as the California Theater of the Performing Arts, the former movie palace now hosts the San Bernardino Symphony and several other touring companies, which include Sinfonia Mexicana and the Inland Dance Theater. The theater puts on several plays, concerts, recitals, and other performances annually. However, the connection to old Hollywood can still be felt in the theater through Carlo Ponti Jr., the current conductor of the San Bernardino Symphony. He is the son of movie actress Sophia Loren, pictured here at the theater with former San Bernardino Mayor Judith Valles and Republican Congressman Jerry Lewis. Many who have attended the symphony have marveled at how the theater adds to their experience. One of these individuals is Cal State San Bernardino professor Donna Cooley.
We have five symphonies a year, and I attend all five of those. But I love the idea of the theater. And since it's been, you know, refurbished inside, it's just beautiful. The ambiance, I think, looking around you is part of the experience of hearing the music, because you're looking at a beautiful surrounding.
Due to its remarkable transformation over the decades, the California Theater remains a vital modern-day attraction for individuals young and old.